fly-off at the first World Championship F5J, Trnava 2019. I move to the edge of the field. I don't dare to stand in the middle of the field anymore, because these guys, they will launch low. There's no doubt about it. They have enough wind indications what the wind is doing. We have some showers all around the field. Plenty of thermals, and I'm sure soon plenty of downdrafts as well. When those showers over there reach us, it's gonna be interesting. Low on the trees immediately, and more or less the whole group did the same thing. Even the guys who were at the closest to the camp in the first starting points, they are now here over the corn. Some lower, some higher. And the lowest one, I think, is Arjen Hutseluk, with distinctive horizontal stabilizer, which is tilted downwards a bit. Makes it out of this, then all of them will make it. Arjen and another guy are still struggling there. Don't know why that guy is so stuck onto Arjen. And there's one plane about 40 meters above them, and the rest of the group has already scattered downwind with the thermal that has blown past here. And if I'm not mistaken, most of them are already coming back, because this airway that Arjen was now in looks like it's now starting to go up. So still all 14 pilots look to aim for the same thermal, and I just hope nothing bad happens. It's quite congested airspace now there. I mean, look at that. You have time to count all the planes now that are in the picture. Thank you. crash now at this height, I'm not sure if they'll be able to find the plane in time. It will be blown somewhere with the wind and it's end in some tree somewhere. A mile away or so. I really hope nothing bad happens. So who's the lowest now? This guy, and I'm sure he has enough height to feel comfortable, not really stressed, and he's also flying alone. He's not in that crowd up there, so I would say he's in the best position right now. He has enough time, enough height to find his own thermal, get some height, and not get stressed about all the other planes in the vicinity. The rest of the planes are, I would say, 600 meters plus already, so they just need to spend the time somewhere and make sure they are not blown away. I lost that guy, that was the lowest. Not sure where he is now. Away for a moment, I don't see him anymore. Now unpleasantly high. I just hope no one is taken, eaten by a cloud that's now coming over us. And I hope this round ends before the shower starts, because behind my back showers are already uncomfortably close. Guys here. If I can find them first. I think this guy is the lowest of the bunch. And even he is just a tiny speck out there. So that was, I would say, from 20 meters to 800 meters in something like 5 minutes or so. idea of how much these clouds are sucking everything underneath them. But if the showers come by, they will change everything. I see someone returning to the line, fetching his plane. Not sure who that is. So someone did land and didn't make the initial climb with the group. With these load starts, there's no room for error. So if you misread the air a bit, maybe 50 meters left or right, and don't make the connection to the thermal immediately, then you're out. Jesus, that's high. But I guess there's nothing else for me to do but to move to the landing points in hope that showers don't arrive in the next 5 minutes. Here we are at the landing points. This will now be a full crosswind landing. Wind is blowing almost in my face. And it's just a very tiny component blowing down the runway. And I expect approaches to be done over me, from the cornfield out down to the landing points. Not sure how comfortable I feel about that, but looks like no one is really behind me anymore. They're all down on the over the runway, so it's okay. Very crowded. And no crashes. And look at that. Planes aligned like on a parade, landing in this kind of wind. This tells you that these guys are really top of the world. Not bothered by any difficult landing conditions. Congratulations. Now I guess we have to wait out that storm. It's not yet there, but it will be there if we wait for 10 more minutes. Then there's another shower passing just south of us, and this one will most likely miss us. So yeah, thermals in Trnava. Second senior flyoff with that shower just behind our backs. Luckily the wind is blowing somehow diagonally past it, so there's a chance it might miss us. That's what organizer is pushing for. Now the second group, second start for the seniors. 10 seconds to go, let's see what they will do. Arian again low and slow, slightly downwind, trying the air immediately on the start. And only getting more energy into the plane in the last few seconds. He's again by far the lowest and the only one downwind actually. The rest of the group went over the red hangar. That's interesting. Let's see how this develops. He will have to work the whatever list he can find here. At least he's in a much better position to observe what his plane is doing and where the lift is. He's now some 70 meters high. And the wind is dying down. That's what worries me. I just hope that rain is not the next thing we get. Nothing. Just hanging there over the trees. And I see three planes that are joining him from the top. Interesting here. So he's already walked closer to the where the action is to see better what's happening. And the rest are slowly coming from the red hangar now overhead runway, slowly going downwind at different heights. Still at the moment Arjan is the lowest. But if he can hang there a few more minutes, it looks like there's a patch of better air coming. Now this requires really precise flying and understanding of how air is moving across the trees, or flowing I should say, because you really need to guide your plane through that waves of the fluid motion. Now I think all of the planes are now over the cornfield. No, there's one still far upwind for some reason. them are also having difficulties. So there's now one also joining Arjan over the trees, hoping to gain some more minutes of flying. But he decided to try it a bit further behind the trees. Let's see how this works out. But Arjan is still where he was. I just hope now there's enough height difference between the two. Now there's a third one. I just wanted to say that I hope there's enough room between the two, but it's getting crowded there now. There's no room for maneuvering here. And the fourth one went across and went for landing, okay. Like another one is approaching from behind. There are now four planes hanging there. And 2 minutes 40 seconds to go, if I can see the clock correctly. This is getting busy. Two more approaching from above. Pilots there, they need to go back to the points. So one is in too far in front, might end up in the corn. There's also one in front, maybe able to climb back up. So one did land in the corn. Okay, 1 minute 45 seconds to go, and I feel the first rain. I guess we'll fly this to the end. Still busy around there. Guys are now running to the points, because now they need to score a point or a landing. Clock is ticking down. One minute to go. Two, four, six planes remained out of 14. One's in the corn. Looks like the other seven already landed. Yeah, now every second counts. 20 seconds. I think Arjan will be the first to land, because he was the lowest, he can do that. No, that's not Arjan. Where is he? Yes, yeah, that was him, yeah. Impressive, impressive. Now I think there's gonna be a bit of a break to let the showers pass by. And then we continue with juniors. Third flight of senior flyoffs. And looks like we have some luck with weather. I've heard pilots call these kind of clouds atmospheric water pumps, and that's what they are. Because the ones over there behind us are dumping now all the water they pumped up into the atmosphere, and here we have just a few raindrops, and looks like we'll remain dry for the remaining of the competition. No idea what pilots will do now. Because right now there's really nothing to do at low height. Everyone is climbing over the hangars and trees to the west. I saw just two planes that went up the runway and one a bit downwind. And now I have no idea whom to follow. Let's try this guy, he's the closest. And he seemed to be in good air. So Arjan now has enough lead in the score, so he doesn't need to risk anymore. He can do a high start and just spend 15 minutes in the air somewhere safely. And let the others fight for the second and third place. It looks a bit busy there over the starting line. And based on the shape of his tail, this is Arjan. He didn't launch all that high. And the air doesn't seem to be any good for all of the guys here over the start line. And behind in the cornfield, the guys also lost a lot. Even the guys who launched high up the runway are losing height, but they still have enough since they launched high. So the game is still on. I think this is now Emil with his Cyclone, who's circling here at a really low height. Looks like there's slight lift there, but not enough to do a tight circle. This needs to be flown much more gently, probably without turning at all. And this will cost him another short flight. again, crowd gathering around that tree line, but this time with barely any wind. At least where I'm standing, it's currently completely quiet. Someone's trying some tight turns over the landing points, but I'm just in preparation for landing. So currently it looks the best for the guys who went over the cornfield and upwind. Up the runway, sorry. So looks like the upper tree line is giving them something, because what's happening here is tight and messy. It's really close to the trees, too close for comfort. Not sure if there's any wind at all. It won't work this time, this is too low. Yeah, too low, too close. At least plane is not in the corn, but that's now a zero for him. Okay, so the game is on. Nothing is decided yet. More planes trying their luck there. This one won't even make it to the landing point, or just barely. Four more planes there with fourth going for a landing anyway. Two more circling. One more going for landing. Guys are still in the air. One's about to land though, but back there looks like they could make it. At least the one above. Make it back after this. But now that the shower has moved south of from us, wind has died out surprisingly. And there's the next shower coming actually. This one might dump some rain on us. Let's wait and see. There are two more planes actually on this side of the airfield. Don't know where they were hanging this time. Apparently somewhere behind me. much better chance to stay in the air the longest, because there at the field line there's just one plane left, and lower than they are, getting ready to land. I think this is Primož Rižner, based on the tiny winglets at his wingtips. Yeah, it helps a lot to see some fashion items added to the planes, at least something that I can tell them apart by. But yeah, he's also going to land. Yep. And the last one is now here. Organizer just announced there will be a refly. Didn't see why, who asked for it. But this is now a chance for all the pilots that landed early to get a better score. Now this guy is fighting for every second. And if he gets now 1000 points, he can afford to launch a refly much lower. Okay, so let's wait for a refly. We are now waiting for a refly on the third start for seniors. It looks like the shower that was north of us is somehow dissipating, and wind is picking up again. So let's see what people will do. I guess some of them will try that magic tree line to my right again. No one. Okay, one is going right directly toward the tree line. Others are climbing slowly towards the buildings. Now one is flying towards me, and that's end of 30 seconds. Sun is also now peeking out, but I guess just tiny bit too late. So the flock is now all over the sky, but majority is here, where I'm pointing my camera at. But the interesting development is behind me. So this guy started down the runway, found nothing, is now moving towards the trees here, trying to join the rest of them. Let's see if he can get anything. There's one more plane, or even three behind. behind me already. They're trying to get something downwind. And there's now strong gust of wind. So definitely something's happening there. That was a good read. But it's also dying down quickly. So it's not yet bulletproof. Now another gust. And they're moving over the runway again. There are also some swallows joining them. That's always a good sign. But they went straight across the runway. Didn't stop for a second. Okay, so the lowest guy has issues. If he will even make it back to the points. Now that's over 75 meters. Now what? Two more coming back, losing height rapidly, and a couple of planes over my head. This is getting quite busy around me, more than what I would like, and there are still a few more upwind, but planes are dropping like flies around here. Particularly low this time, but still it wasn't high enough. Looks like it's one of those days where just four launches at 200 meters will bring you a victory. But then again, no one would provide a show like this over the tree line. That's also worth something. Unfortunately, it's not measured by the score. And this one can't hold a stick to Arjan and is going to land as a consequence. Flying and where? There are now three planes downwind and three planes upwind. No idea whom to choose. Okay, let's go this way.
I see this is Arjan. So he went for a safer choice this time. He needs to have a result. Above me. He's now moved slightly behind me and into the path of these three guys here, which are returning from far downwind, apparently not being able to find anything to stay in the air. Maybe that wasn't the best decision by him. Two more planes on the ground. Arjan is again at the tree line. Looks to be his favorite toy. And I guess he can make it again because there's not enough wind. And that wasn't there before. There's now also some sun coming out. And I guess the last flight will be really, really interesting. So besides Arjan hanging there, there are two more planes in the air. And they're circling quite happily. There isn't much of a lift, but maybe for the guy that's further downwind, he's in a good air. Up here in the front doesn't look too good. But maybe you just need to be patient. Wind has now increased, so there's sure something to happen. Could be this is Primož again, so could be a good result for him too. Yeah, Arjan still at the tree line doing his trick. Something good for him. Now the other guy is a bit behind joining. Back, and the guy behind him lost lots of height just trying to reach him. Arjan still hanging there. Oh, there's a fourth plane in the air joining him. I missed that guy. Still, let's see how the drama here develops.
again flying back towards the trees here, hoping to get the bubble unsticking from them. Now this period of sun won't last long because there's now one huge cumulus cloud that will cover it soon. And there's another plane over there, so looks like there are more people still flying. And this will be again above my head. Minutes are valuable. Pretty much decided to give up. At least he gets a landing this way, and that's all that counts for something. In the meantime, Arjan's still hanging there. He's alone, so he can do it as precise as he wants. And then there are again planes above me. Landing. Another sound of happiness from the Croatian team. And I don't know what happens now with these black clouds here. At least we are sure to get the shade and maybe some gusts of wind. Now juniors will have to deal with this. Final act of this world championship. Fourth flight of the senior flyoffs. We had to wait for the shower to pass. That took us about 1 hour. But it's still early enough in the afternoon to do the last flight and even a reflight if necessary. So the wind has died down considerably. And the sky looks less dangerous. Much more benign. But like still the sun is hiding. And I don't really expect much thermals. So the results from the previous three flights are published, and I expect people to try and protect their current ranking, because differences are already high enough that something extreme must happen for first three to change places. So I do hope this last flight is now just a formality. Seconds. I don't expect anyone to go low. And no one is really wasting their energy unnecessarily hanging there and waiting for something to come by. Arjan went far up the runway and just parked there at height. He has a comfortable 80 point lead from the second place, and he's flying to retain that lead. These two planes are slightly in a downwind position. But maybe looking at wind direction, very few winds there, but still they are pointing into the wind. So there are a few more planes already low, and then there's one pilot who decided not to start this fourth flyoff at all. Apparently he has enough flying for today. there's no magic now here. Rain has cooled down everything and there's no sun yet. So any low level circling is just wasting your potential energy. Next one to land is probably this guy here. Although there's one on the other side of the runway at a similar height. Second down, there's a third one landing. See where Arjan is now, but I have a good overview of what's happening near me. And it's getting quite busy here over the camp. there's now a bit of wind and there's some hope maybe for these guys here. You see the tape at the pole pointing towards them. That's always a good sign. Happiness. There are two more planes in the air. Applause, congratulations, I guess both for to the pilots and to the organizer of this championship. Turned out very well, no major issues. We even fought the weather and now as it is customary, we finished flying and the sun has come out. We now wait for the result. And it will be all very well known before you watch this video. But I'll wait anyway and include it in the end. Thank you for watching.
Primo GPT, yeah. Okay.
Official final results.
Okay, sorry. Let's do live on Facebook. Live.